When the boys were away, the house was very quiet. But when the boys came home, the house woke up and was full of stir. Sometimes we had friends to tea and played hide-and-seek in the garden, but I liked it better when we were alone and went into the drawing-room after tea for music. On Sunday evenings we had hymns, but on weekdays Father sang old songs, songs which had been old when he was young, such as "A Fox Jumped Up in a Hungry Plight," and "The Man That Broke the Bank at Monte Carlo," and "Ring the Bell, Watchman." Unlike the songs of modern times, they all had good, rousing tunes. I remember those evenings so well. I remember the comfortable, lamp-lit room, Father at the grand piano, playing and singing in his mellow baritone, Mother sitting by the fire with her mending basket, humming and beating time, and all of us standing round and joining in the choruses. Every now and then Father would put his fingers in his ears and exclaim, "Softly, softly, catchy monkey." None of us knew where the quotation came from, but we all knew what Father meant. We took it in turns to choose the songs. Willie's favourite was "The Fox," and mine was an old ditty with several verses. I can't remember them now, but only the chorus, which came at the end of each verse. "Dashing away with a smoothing iron, dashing away with a smoothing iron, she stole my heart away." We all sang quite nicely when we didn't shout, but Lewis's voice was beautiful. It was a boy's treble, clear as a bell. In the holidays, Lewis sang in the choir. One Sunday morning, he stood up and sang, "Oh, for the Wings of a Dove." He looked so angelic, and his voice was so pure and unearthly that I was quite frightened. I was even more frightened when Mrs. Quayle, who sat in the pew behind us, whispered to her sister that he was too good for this world,